What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the OceanBlock Minecraft modpack. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In a regular Minecraft world, you're going to be spending a lot of time on land, and you really only enter the ocean if you're trying to get from one place to the next. But if you're looking for a new challenge revolving around this ocean, then the OceanBlock modpack is perfect for you. Using this pack challenges players to overcome difficulties and discover new ways of exploring, and it comes with a quest book to help you get there. Let's go over how to get started. Before playing FTB OceanBlock, you're going to need to install the pack on the official launcher. Head to the FTB app page and then select your operating system to download the launcher. Open the app and near the bottom left, log into your Minecraft account. And after signing in, you can click Browse on the sidebar to the left and enter FTB OceanBlock in the text box. Click the download button and continue to install on the next page. Wait for that to reach 100% and then you can click go to instance in the following prompt. And from here, you can start playing the modpack to confirm that it works. With the modpack installed on the launcher, now we just have to get the server ready. Head towards your Apex server panel and find the game file section and then click the current version, revealing a drop-down menu. Here you can look up FTB OceanBlock in the search box and then select it and change version. In the next prompt, press Generate New World and then Restart Now to start loading the modpack. And once everything is loaded and online, you can join using the FTB app with OceanBlock installed. When entering an OceanBlock world, you're going to immediately see the modded features. These include an entirely custom water world with special blocks. Your first step is going to be creating an island. This is done through the /FTB Team Islands Create command with no permissions required to use it. Luckily, you are going to have some options when making an island, varying in different biomes and sizes, among other aspects. Make sure to choose wisely, since this is most likely the only land you're going to encounter. Once you've created an island, using the /My Island command will transport you back to it. This is going to be helpful if you're lost in the ocean or if you're stranded somewhere else. There are quite a few types of islands that can be created, with some being made by players or taken from other modpacks. You can select one of the following categories, and these have unique lands to choose from, but they range in difficulty depending on your playstyle. The first category is the most popular and the easiest one to start out with. These different main islands are the island, the cottage, and the skyblock. The first one challenges players to create and manage their own base, and the second one is a lot easier as it provides you with an already built structure and farm. The last variant is a basic skyblock layout with little land and resources to start with. Now that you've created an island, the next step is going to be opening your quest book. Players can use this for learning new crafting recipes, understanding more about items, and keeping track of where you're supposed to be. For instance, starting out tends to involve gathering basic resources to slowly progress. This is exactly what you're going to need to do in the Getting Wood quest, providing you with rewards and advancements. Just click the materials in the rewards section to receive them after completing a quest. If you're stuck on a particular quest, then you can click on one of the tasks to reveal its recipe or its information. This comes in handy when you need to build specific items or blocks, but you don't know how to actually craft them. This can also show other required materials that can complete the quest, so there might actually be more than one way to advance. Later in the quest, such as basic tools, you're going to need to craft equipment. This requires two interactive blocks, a part builder and a tinker station. The first one allows players to make specific parts of tools, like an axe head, and then once enough is collected, the second block combines them into a desired item. I recommend crafting a wooden mattock first, which can be viewed in-game from the Tinker Station's GUI. Regardless of the island you create, managing your farms and bases are required, and depending on the island you choose, you're going to have to manually create them to stay alive. Popular farms include wheat and trees, since these items come in handy for both food and building materials for weapons, tools, and more. After successfully establishing a strong island, then you're probably going to want to explore. If there are special structures nearby, you can try to swim towards them, but be careful because you're going to get mining fatigue and slowness after surfacing. Using a boat is going to bypass these effects, allowing you to easily explore the world without having to swim. There are sometimes underwater buildings that are going to be much harder to reach, but these are usually reserved for later when players have the proper equipment. One of the easiest and most popular methods for looting is breaking barrels on rafts. These are commonly scattered throughout the ocean, making it widely available. In them, there can be furniture, equipment, or materials for craftable items. In cases where you can't play OceanBlock from the FTB app, make sure the modpack is updated to the latest version. This can be done by clicking versions to the right of the play button from the pack. It also could be that you failed to sign into your Microsoft account. This is required on the FTB launcher to play, since it's going to allow you to join servers and use single-player worlds. If your world isn't the ocean I described at the beginning, then head back into your server panel and try uploading the mod pack again, making sure to choose to create a new world before restarting the server. You could also create an island in single player and upload it to the server, which we do have a guide to that I will have linked down below. If you're looking for a challenge outside of the vanilla game, there are tons of mod packs to choose from, but why not start with this one? It's not the hardest mod pack to get used to, and it's a good way to practice farming, collecting resources, and more. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.